If you arrive at the site, there's these beautiful sand dunes and pyramids look like they're being engulfed by these sand dunes. It's out of some sort of romance novel. It's gorgeous. The pyramids at Nuri are built about a mile away from the Nile River. Now, because of natural climate change, human-aided climate change, and constructions of dams and such along the river, the groundwater has risen in the last 2,500 years to submerge the tombs that are cut into the bedrock underneath the pyramids. In front of the pyramids, they cut a long staircase, 65, 70 stairs, and these go down about 30 feet or 10 meters until you hit the tombs cut into the bedrock underneath the pyramids themselves. So we have to dig down in the stairwell until we hit the water table, and then we have to dig and dive. Well, outside the tomb, the water is actually quite cold and murky because we're kicking it around and excavating, and the wind is whipping and wicking the heat away. But once you get inside, it's still, and the water's pristine. As long as you're not turning up the dirt on the bottom, you can see 5-10 feet when you're underwater. It's really quite remarkable. In each of these tombs, there should be three chambers. First chamber for burial goods, second chamber for burial goods, third chamber all the way in the back is where the king would be buried. When we got into the third chamber, we found a little table cut into the back wall. And on the table were still sitting the remnants of the little gold offerings left for the king. Well, it's thrilling, it's exciting, it's an impressive responsibility to be able to have that opportunity to tell these stories with our colleagues and really try to rebuild this part of history that we don't know very well.